Myself Bhargavi, and now I'm a mechanical trainer for you, teach the CAD softwares and all. So today I'm going to introduce my about the what are the advantages of choosing this learning this CAD/CAM courses and all. So how they are useful for us from the graduation level and afterwards how we improve with the technical skills and all for the future jobs, career applications and all. I'm going to see. So how what are the advantages of learning this software and how we have to prolong with the software. I'll be introducing you. Okay, so why we are choosing design softwares in mechanical? We what is the use of choosing this design? So what is the use of choosing this design area for the one second, I'm sorry. So what are the advantages of learning the softwares practically, and how we design the prototypes or geometric applications of complete prototypes and the development of a machinery or development of a tool or whatever thing. We study in our graduation about the mechanical concepts in where we cover all the machinery tools, machinery equipments, designing area and all. So why we are choosing the softwares? Well, we used to previously in 20 years back to design a particular prototype and all, we just choose practically we will draw the designs with respect to drafters or using in a very big areas of A4 sheets and all. So in our India, we gradually do the designs in particular some amount of paper sizes only, limited amount of, like there are some ISO standardized paper sizes. So in through that paper sizes only we will design complete design development of a prototype and all. We will be doing that by using drafters, scales, instruments, protractors, set squares and all. So by using that, we face many problems even by technically and by practically also, by because paper waste will be there, and by doing that it takes a long time. But nowadays in this 20th century we need, especially we have to make a very important thing in our life is time. So if we go in the same old process, we face many problems through that. So we'll undergo this our problem failures and all. Some applications we have learned like CAD, like using the by taking the help of the computers and all, we and prepare the particular designs very easily. So by doing with the pencil or a scale or on the drafter or with the A4 sheet size, it takes time for us. So then if we use this computer aided, like if we use this some softwares which have taken technically by previously after using the drafters, we will do with the lathe machines and all the processor of manufacturing a product and all. Afterwards we used to use like NC and CNC machines. We used to take the help of NC and CNC machines, like manual part programming or computer aided part programming, like that we used to take care. We used to get the guidance through that, and we used to do. But manual drafting is completely different than like by using a computer aided design. So manual draft with this, if you want to understand a particular drawing, for example, I'll take the example of civil constructions. So I am a civil client and I want to construct a 2 BHK or 3 BHK house. So then what I will do, I just if I'm not a technical person, then what I'll do, I just like give a hand with a manual with the freehand sketch on a paper, and I just ask the particular designer to like this. I need to develop my area like this. I need to construct my house like this. So I'll do it like in the freehand shape. So that particular thing, how many can understand? Okay, so that particular idea, whatever idea I want to share with the student, I'll share with the project team, that no, like either he should understand my ideas with the freehand sketch, what I have written on the paper, or else I should explain him in the technical way so that he can understand my concept and get my work done. So what I'll do, what then in particular to complete one particular project and all, there are so many different types of people will be involved in that, work together and complete that particular project and all. So now with freehand sketches, when we give a design, no one can understand that particular way how we have explained the procedure and all. So to understand that particular procedure, we design engineers like civil or mechanical, whatever thing, we design engineers create a technical by using a technical knowledge. Practically we use some concepts, we use some technical words and explain to the particular person who do that work and all. So here I am a design engineer and I explain. So in that to construction of field, there are so many will be there. Even in the mechanical shop workshop also, in a mechanical engineering, we will be finding many of the machine machinery to machine tools, like machine tool equipments and the machinery things, areas and all, workshop, we call them as a workshop. Okay, so to construct anything, there are manually so many labor, we need a labor also. To undertake that labor, we need some person like a supervisor and all. So whatever project I'm going to do, everyone in the project, everyone in the process should be understand. Okay, because different people will be undertaking the work and they will be doing individually. So whatever design I am creating, understand to the particular persons, they should understand clearly. So then what I'll do, manually if we draw with the free hand sketch, we no one can understand. So that's why we use a software tool which is known as AutoCAD. So AutoCAD is a manual like it is a drafting software which can be, which is from Autodesk company, which has introduced by Autodesk company like 15 years back. So there are so many different types of softwares from the AutoCAD. So it is a software tool which can be communicate the particular procedure from the client and the designer. So when the whatever the client is explaining himself about his project, the designer will understand himself and create a complete design layout in the AutoCAD software. So in this, today I am going to explain the fundamentals of CAD/CAM. So here in the fundamentals of CAD/CAM, we give first importance for the design and the design process. As I told you, I need to construct a 2 BHK apartment or 2 BHK thing. I need to explain to a particular designer field about the thing concept. So we mechanical engineers, we create that particular design prototype in 2D diagrams, and we will communicate that 2D means two-dimensional diagrams, two-dimensional view with respect to some axis only, X and Y axis. So you all know about the coordinates. So X coordinate, Y coordinate and Z coordinate. So if you explain about the two-dimensional area, then in two-dimensional, we will show the designs, whatever you are seeing from the two sides only. If I'm seeing that particular, if I'm seeing that project layout from top view. So how many views we have? Top view, side view, and bottom view. Okay. So here, top view, I need to see bottom view, side view like that. If I, for example, a rectangle is there. If I see from the front of view, like I can see a shape of a rectangle. Same thing if I will see from the top view also. If I give the less width to the rectangle, like after creating a block, for example, a block, I need to see in the front view, but I will see only the rectangle shape. If I will see from the side view, like a slightly in isometric view, then we will find there three directions: x direction, y direction, and z direction. So when we go with these three directions, it's an isometric view. So how, by recognizing this particular rectangle block in the isometric view, I can understand what is the complete shape of the rectangle box and how we have to create and all. So here, first important thing is we have to learn what are main concepts, like how you have to draw the 2D diagram drawing from 2D diagram to how we have to go for 3D, means 3D means three-dimensional view drawing. So first of all, we have to be perfect in 2D, means two-dimensional view drawings. That drawings, in the drawings, you will cover all the company project layouts you will be drawing in the two-dimensional drawings, like a single part, for example, a gear. So I need to design a three-dimensional gear and do analysis on that. Gear is there, right? So I need to I need to draw that diagram. I need to do analysis on it. So directly we won't get that particular gear. If you download from Google or if you download from some, that thing, you cannot find that particular analysis and all. So what we have to do, we design engineers, we work from the softwares, and how we work through that gear application analysis, how we'll do, means we will draw a dimensional 2D dimensional drawing of particular gear with respect to the dimensions which required to complete the gear application. We will draw the 3D line drawing in the AutoCAD software. From there, if you want to create in a 3D modeling softwares, then you will communicate that particular 2D diagrams through IGS and STP files. See, I want to do diagram. I want to create the 2D diagram in AutoCAD softwares only, and I want to develop the 2D to 3D in AutoCAD only, and I must after creating that prototype in the software, how can I understand people? So if each and every person won't be having laptop, each and every person won't be having softwares. So how can I show that particular design, whatever I've designed in drafting softwares, how can I show to a particular client? To formats, change, converting those things into the formats, these layouts, that is like drafting, that is called as a drafting area. There you will choose a paper size and you will make a complete software. You will initiate there, and whatever drawings you have done, you will convert it to the PDF files. Then whatever idea you have done, whatever the project gear example you have done, that you will communicate to the PDF. Then you will take layouts, you will select the paper sizes, you will select from the paper sizes, you will apply each and every dimensions. So how you will explain that particular gear? If you're directly drawing gear and giving the dimensions, is it enough? No. We have to use GDNT concepts. What are the GDNT concepts? Like geometric dimensions and tolerances values. These topics are very important. We have to learn in our graduation. That comes under in third year or second year, depending on their regulation syllabus and all. You have to learn GDNT and tolerances, limits, values. So by, as a mechanical engineer, by seeing that particular values or whatever dimension, limits or symbols you have given to complete a particular gear or a prototype, by seeing the designs, you no need to write there. We won't write, we engineers, mechanical design engineers, we won't write and show in a particular paper layout of a particular diagram. We won't write and everything. We just show the symbols of geometric dimension values, geometric tolerances values, how much depth you are giving, how much hole you are giving. So are you giving a through hole, or if you are giving a half till some limit, till some area you are leaving, like that we will indicate. For example, I'll tell you, we will find some section views. In our 2D diagram, we will find some section views. So how these section views are explained, identified? Whenever a section view is formed, we have to identify that is a sectional area of a 3D diagram. There, by seeing that section view diagram in 2D, we should analyze that it's a hole. Okay, it's a whole a revolving thing. Oh, okay. The giving section means there some, if you are giving some round and giving the section means there, we will identify that here it should be revolved, or it should like rotation or circular applications will be done, like that we'll understand. So this thing, while continuing in the softwares, I'll explain you. But first thing, what I want to tell you is we have to be identify first the 2D diagrams, then we have to identify the 3D diagrams from the manually, then only we can create a prototypes. So creating a prototypes, it won't end the concept of product design. So what we will do first, add CAM CE. We know everyone know that what is CAD, what is CAM, and what is CE means. CAD means computer design or drafting. There you will design and draft the particular concepts with respect to tools. CAM, manufacturing. Then CAE means computer aided engineering. But in our product, in our cycle, design cycle, design process, first we create a CAD, then we go with CAE, then we go with CAM. Why? Because you will design, you will draft there. Okay. After doing a design, you have to do analysis. So how you do the analysis for this softwares? So we use analysis, we do analysis by using analysis softwares, and through in this analysis softwares, what are concepts you will be doing? In how I told you, that doing a design or a drafting, we will learn from the engineering first year only, engineering graphics. There itself, we will learn how to use take a drafter and how we will draw with the pencil, with the set squares, or take the instruments. There you will learn. Next, what you learn in the next further years, if you all are completed BTech, it is well and good that you will understand. If you are very early in the first year, second years means you'll be learning later. But I'll just explain you how we cover, what all we cover in our BTech from first year to the final year. Those things, those procedures only, you will apply in the softwares. It should be very clear to you, whatever the concepts, fundamentals you will learn in the BTech levels upon during a design process, in the design areas only, the development or manufacturing or whatever thing in the design areas only, that you will cover and learn in the softwares. There is there a practical ga, whatever you learn in the BTech and whatever you learn in the softwares, different, it is not different, it is same. There you will create, you will solve the problem. Suppose in the DMM, design of machine members, we have one subject. So there, whatever diagram or a tool, whatever is there, you will learn the procedure of creating that tool. And here you will convert that procedures by using a software tools, and you will create a prototype. It is very simple. When you are very clear in your graduation concepts, then you will be, it is very easy for you to understand the softwares. If you don't know the concepts, simple concepts only, like GDNT topics I have told you. So those all things you have to cover. So then only you can understand the software. So now I'll come back to this fundamentals. First, in analysis, we used to learn finite element methods. Finite element methods is a subject where you can understand the complete analysis concepts on particular procedures and all. So there you will learn FEM subject will be there. There you will learn the analysis things in graduation levels. How the analysis means, it's a very vast and big area. So in the analysis, when coming to the graduation students, we maximum people will teach ANSYS software only. Okay, in analysis, in CAE, they are all when we go for a company level or a worldwide, there are so many softwares. So many are using so many different softwares. Depends on the companies and upon their manufacturing or production layout, they use different softwares. But when coming to the graduation students, they learn maximum two softwares which are known as ANSYS and HyperMesh. These are the both two softwares immediately after BTech, or when they are doing the software, then they are doing the final projects or fourth years. Maximum students will learn the analysis softwares only two. They are ANSYS and work like HyperMesh. So when coming for the ANSYS, the board ANSYS, I'm not having any PPTs. I just explain you orally. When we start learning about the softwares, I'll explain you clearly about that. Okay, so I just brief explain you now what are the advantages of ANSYS softwares and all I'll tell you. So we'll be going by using these things. ANSYS, in ANSYS you will be having two types. ANSYS APDL you will be learning and ANSYS Workbench. They are the two different softwares procedures you will learn in the ANSYS. Okay, so now the explanation of CAD, CAM and CAE is done. Okay, so first we will create a design. We will do analysis. Then you do analysis. If you won't get any errors, if you get the accurate result only, then you will go for the manufacturing procedure. So this is a design process thing. So CAD, CAE and CAM. Okay, so coming back to the PPT. So here what you learn in this mechanical is about the product design, what are the hardwares, what are the software tools we use. You learn like this. So fundamentals of CAD, these all things you know. What are the ICGs means? Interactive computer graphics. Interactive computer graphics means here we use the computers with by using some softwares, by using some graphic oriented tool things. So by using their like procedure programming things, we designers will communicate that particular whatever the concept is there, we communicate through this devices, computer device. And CRT is a communication for all the manual drafting to the design drafting. It is a continuation thing. So as I told you in the design process, recognition of a need is your project. Then you will identify a problem. Synthesis means there you will utilize the softwares of 2D and you will convert it to 2D to 3D diagrams to create a prototype. After prototype completing in the CAD procedure, you will go for analysis and optimization. So here in the analysis optimization only, you will clear your all the things in the procedures of analysis softwares. Then you will do how much load you are giving, how much what all the engineering materials you are applying to that product, everything you will see and apply there. Afterwards in the evaluation, if you are getting the correct thing, then only you will go for the manufacturing process and all. Okay, sir, I just want to continue orally itself. After telling about the brief explanation of ANSYS, I'll show you the ANSYS in ANSYS tool, how you design a simple example and all, I'll show you. So after this learning about these analysis softwares, we have two analysis softwares, which are APDL and Workbench. In APDL, you will be giving all the manual applications there. In APDL software, all the manual applications. For example, when we are going for the manufacturing purpose, directly, practically, we use CNC and lathe machines. Okay, in CNC and lathe machines, the operator and everything should be there itself. Manual operations only will be there to complete the tool and all. Everything will be done manually in the lathe machines. Afterwards in CNC, some programming we will apply with the G codes and M codes. We will create a programming and we will create a prototype. To create a prototype, we give a program. So some technically we have done. Then how it comes with the computer aided, how we use with the computer aided. So whatever this thing practically you are done, it takes more time by doing, suppose screw, nut or screw I want to do in a drilling operation or in a simple machine I want to create manually, it takes more time. If I need very fast and I need to get more number of jobs, then what I'll do, I'll create a program and I'll insert that program in the CNC machine tool, like then there I'll get n number of screws at a time. So that is the advanced process. Similarly, in the analysis also, we, like for example, companies like BHEL, like old companies are there, some basic government sector companies are there, BHEL, DRDO, for small thing analysis, small particle analysis, means we will do by doing inspections or inspection on tool like that we will do, or else if you want to do analysis or check the material thing, means you will do by using the laboratories for identifying the material application and all, you will see that. But if I want to go with the analysis purpose of, well, like help of turbines and all, I want to check the turbines, like blades, wherever in the high, for example, in a huge tanks, water flow, how I want to check that flow, whether the flow is coming correct or not. When the flow is applying, the hot flow or cold flow, or whatever the things. Flow means fluid area. In fluid, you can identify air, water, and fuels also. So when we pass these all fuels through the tanks, fuel pipes, and then how you identify and how you analyze whether the particular material of that particular pipes and everything is force with respect to whatever force it is going, how much force it is going, when it is with some velocity it was flowing from one end to another, is it going in a correct way or not, or else what any damage is applying to the material of pipe, and how do you identify them? If small things means, see, for example, a chair, we'll take a particular chair, we will have different type. I'm just explaining why we do the analysis, why we choose the analysis. I'm just explaining. For example, if we take a chair, different materials of chair we'll be finding. Okay, we'll find wood, plastic, like fiber chairs, and like different from very low cost to the high expensive, different types of chairs we'll identify, and quality also it will change. So if I give a particular fire or whatever thing to some plastic chair or wood chair or anything, what happens immediately? It will damage very easily. If you apply fire for a wood material, within minutes only it will damage. Okay, if you do for a steel or iron also, it will damage, or the material will melt, or something will happen, disaster shape will get. But I need a perfect quality. See, I am a manufacturer, and I want to design a beautiful or a very standard quality of a quality having chair, and I want to introduce that particular chair to the market. Then I am not a man. I am a manufacturer. I don't know the procedure of analysis. And then how we will check is that particular material of the cycle, chair is very perfect. You can go for the manufacture and all. How I'll design? How I'll do that? We designer, mechanical engineers, we do this process. We do a 2D. As I told you before, previously, we design them, and before prototyping, we will do analysis in the softwares by giving different types of materials, applying on that. And here, ANSYS is only a testing. ANSYS is only a testing software. It is not a finalized software. See, if you are doing analysis on the software, checking this value, accurate result, this is not the final one. Here, you will learn the procedure and get accurate result. Accurate means exact result. To get accurate result, you will do here, then you will go for the manufacture. If any failures you are getting, again you will go back to design, you will change the modifications in the design, and again you come back, do the same procedure of analysis. If you want to do any different type of analysis, you will do, and then you go for the final manufacturing. From there, you will produce your prototypes to the market field. So temperature is very important. Velocities are very important. So some basic concepts or fundamentals are very important to learn by doing analysis. Blindly, we cannot start the analysis. softwares. Before knowing this analysis softwares, we need to learn some basic mechanical concepts, how and what is velocity. Okay, if you are doing some projects and all, you should identify the problem. Okay, this should be updated. So what is Newton per mm square? You should convert them immediately. So I'll tell you and I'll explain you very briefly when I start the software. So you should, before only learning the softwares, you should be clearly understand the concepts directly. If you do the analysis like this words, this numerical values, okay, I'm applying 10 newtons per meters in a small diameter of ball, I'm applying force. It is not the analysis. You should know how much, on how much quantity, how much material, on which material, how much force we should apply, and with how much velocity we should give. Everything we should know clearly before going with the learning the softwares. Okay, blindly by doing applying on a like on a taking some example, a small ball of diameter of 10 mm, I want to throw 1000 newtons. So what happens, madam? Oh, what result I'll get in analysis softwares? Like that we should not do. So my dear students, before going to the learning the softwares, you please make up your mind, you learn some basic concepts. If you need any guidance, you can ask anyone, we all will help you. But before going softwares also, I'll guide you how to learn the softwares. The agenda is, you should, if any problem is coming, if you are work, even you go and work in the, immediately you won't select for, after completing your BTech, immediately you won't go and select for analysis software engineer. So in slow by slow, you have to do after, you have to go for the 3D softwares engineer, then within 2, 3, 4 like years of experience only, learning the softwares, 2, 3 years only, you will get the position FEA. Okay, FEA engineering, like that. So there, by doing this experience only, you will get more knowledge when from the basic things only. So now, why then, why after the job I should know now, why I'm learning now only in my BTech means? In BTech, when you learn to the fun, like immediately freshly you're coming out, it will help you in your projects analysis. Nowadays, no one are going practically and doing the live projects. No students, there are very some students. So everyone are depending on automatic answer results only. So we have updated, right, from lathe machines to CNC, from CNC to now we are having Mastercam, Delcam. There are so many softwares for manufacturing and all. So we are even having some softwares in analysis, ANSYS. So this is the ANSYS software. I will explain you afterwards about complete software also. But now I will draw. You just kindly see what I'm doing, how I'm drawing and all. In this software, I'm just taking a simple example of a block. Okay. And I'm extruding that particular block. You should know what is block, extrude, options, everything you should know. That I'll tell in when we are using the softwares, I'll tell you. If you are very new to the SCAD design softwares, I'll explain you each and everything. So what you find in the software means everything will be there. In our AutoCAD software, you will find 2D diagram tools, designing tools, and some basic 3D design tools. Updation of 3D modification tools you won't be finding in AutoCAD software. Why? Because that software configuration, it cannot support. So that's why in our mechanical, we are having advanced softwares. So advanced softwares using like Kriya, Catia, SolidWorks, UniGraphics. There are so many modeling softwares which are very advanced of AutoCAD. But without AutoCAD, you cannot learn these all softwares. So through this AutoCAD only, your journey will start from creating 2D to 3D and from analysis. So you should be perfect. All the concepts here. Same thing, whatever the 2D tools and 3D tools are there, in ANSYS software also you'll find. So in this ANSYS software, see, so all the companies won't use same softwares, similar softwares. So now I'm having one company and I'm having ANSYS softwares. I need 2D diagrams, and 3D modification, 3D prototype. One, suppose, for example, I'll tell I need a rectangle box, for example, only same whatever I'm showing now. I need a box 2D to 3D, 3D to I want to do analysis on that. So I want to do only Ansys softwares. Don't use any modeling softwares. Then what you will do? Ansys also, we are having 2D, 3D analysis tools in this Ansys software. So which Ansys we are having, APDL or Workbench? APDL is completely manual only. It is a step by step. Advance of APDL is Workbench software. In this Workbench softwares, you are having completely advantages in this. So two softwares we are having in Ansys, but we are learning only Ansys Workbench. Why? Because in the APDL, you should give everything in sequential order only. Suppose you have started the 2D processing and all. Immediately, if you want to change any 2D, you want to change any 2D designing procedures, you want to change or give fillet or whatever you want to do, again you cannot go back. You have to complete close the program and again you have to start from the starting only. So that is some disadvantages having in APDL. But this APDL softwares like DHCL, old companies who have started from long back days, or like before 10-15 years back, who have started this analysis in their companies, they are using. And now in MNC companies or like some manufacturing high-end, like a small scale, big scale manufacturing companies, they are depending upon this advanced analysis procedures only. So in this Workbench, you are having so many advantages. I'll tell you later. In this Workbench, you will learn 2D. You can create 2D, 3D and do analysis also. Three things you can do. And one more advantage of this Ansys Workbench is, you will design, you will do analysis. Then how you show somewhere in Bangalore your client project sir will be there, or if you are doing any project also, you will be in one place, your sir will be in another place. Then how you show your project or analysis procedure to that particular person? The simple way is, here you will have some IGS files will be there. In this Ansys softwares, you can create whatever documentary is there. So finally, graduation, final year students, what they do? What is the use of learning all these things? You want to create a project file, right? Project data, like completely you should have. So there you will have some advantages that converting the complete project into PDF. So from starting to ending, what all the procedures you have done in this analysis procedure, it will create a documentary. That with visualization of the pictures or whatever in softwares you have done procedures, everything, the documentary will be created automatically in Workbench. But in APDL, we get some failures. You cannot get clearly. 3D you can do, but in 3D you will be finding some difficulties. But when coming to the Ansys Workbench software, here complete analysis procedure will be converted into the documentary, and even the procedure of the format, that file can be downloaded. You can download and you can check your but person should have same softwares. So if I'm using 16 version, the person whom you're sending your client, you're sending your analysis procedure, even that person should have the same software and the same version only. If you are using the 20th version and designing in 16 version, your client is having a 20th version, if you share him, he cannot see. Okay, there are some advantages, everything are there. So finally, so immediately you will do analysis and send to your person, and from there he will download it from zip link or from the net, and he can check. Okay, you have done this procedure and not. So if you are doing any thing, again you can come back. So there are so many advantages in the software, I'll tell you. So now I'm going to design a small example tool, and afterwards I have some projects I have done. So briefly I will show that videos also within 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, So everyone can see the software?
Yes, 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 madam, you can continue.
So, okay, thank you, sir. So opening the software tools should be shared, everything will learn later. So you just see carefully, and what I'm going to do, you just see, is it simple or easier, you will understand, okay? So now I'm choosing a small problem. That problem you will find in strength of materials, your BTEC. So taking some small block, doing that beam problem, okay? One more important thing is, in this analysis workbench, you can import the, suppose I have some gear or big designers, like complex designs will be having now. That thing you cannot create. That means creating the, like it is that much advanced tools like that, you cannot create in ANSYS software. Then how you will solve, how you will do analysis? You can do in 3D softwares. You can export that particular data or tool through IGS file to the analysis software. So directly, whatever 3D prototype you have created in the, suppose for example Unigraphics or CATIA software I'm doing, there only you can create a gear or piston rod, whatever thing how you want to design, you can design and you can import it. You can import in this ANSYS workbench with respect to units and all. So there, if you are doing in MM, here you are doing in T, in the screen, down you are having some scale. So here you are having meters, but you have designed the 3D prototype in CATIA in units MM. So if you convert here, this is the main thing. If you do single mistake in the starting itself, complete analysis will become wrong. So you should check step by step. I'll explain you in the course time. So first thing you have to do is, I just explain slightly, because if I do myself only, you people cannot understand what I'm going to do. So first important thing is, we should set the units with respect to the prototype. Either we are creating here itself in the ANSYS software, or else we are importing the software tool from another CAD software. But the main thing is units. Units are very important. So afterwards, let's see. So this is preview. Preview means from whichever view you are seeing, only the wireframe line diagrams you will be finding out. No solid body, you won't be find it. So in 2D means you will find only line diagrams. That is a 2D view. So now in the screen, I am having a block of a polygon of a four sides, which is also called a square. So I have given 100 mm to this block, square line diagram. And now when I click in this red button, you can see that particular square in 3D line, like in three dimension view. So now x direction, y direction, z direction, you can see side view, okay? So now I want to create this line diagram into a solid model. So I have tool here which is known as extrude. It converts that particular whatever closed loop diagram you have. This is known as closed loop diagram. So it will convert into the solid model. So So now this is a solid model. On this solid model, I am assuming this solid model as a beam, okay? And I want to check, see, this is only solid model. Materials are different. There are so many materials. So now what I'm going to show is, what I'm going to solve the problem is, this is a beam, and this beam is having aluminium material. On this aluminium beam, I want to give some bending, like I want to apply some force in the middle, and I want to see the bending force or damaging the deformation stage. Deformation means damaging stage, where, at which point, and with how much deformation I'm getting on this material, and all I want to see. Then how we will apply, change the materials and all. It is only a simple beam example. So how we will apply the materials? We will apply the materials here. In engineering data, we will apply the materials. Double click on that. So here structural steel is there. If I want aluminium, I can add the materials also. The aluminium alloy is there. If we want concrete, so we are doing beam now. We are assuming that particular 3D model as a beam. So beam is, you can apply concrete or structural steel material, add it. So here you can find each material properties of each concrete material properties, all density, everything. No need of applying. So here the data, in engineering data only, all the materials will be having. If you want to change, you can change. I'll tell you later how you change and all. So here you can apply different material. So now in this analysis, we want to check this on this different types of, I'm applying some force. After applying that force, how it will get damaged, and we won't need a direct damage result. So if I'm applying this much load, what happens to that product? I want to see. So I want to see that particular result with respect to different materials. That is my concept. So further we'll go for next procedure. The geometry you have cleared. Have done. Now you will start doing the analysis. So, and one more important thing is, I want to tell you, this TANSYS workbench is consists of three types: pre-processing, solver, and post-processing procedures. You will have in the software three procedures. What is pre-processing means? Creating a 2D diagram, 2D to 3D. There you are creating the pre-processing method. 2D, creating 3D and prototype. In solver, you will give all the load conditions, what all to be applied, and what all the forces. Not only forces, here you will learn some different types of analysis: structural analysis, thermal analysis, fluid analysis, like mode analysis. There are different types. I want to apply load, I want to apply velocity, I want to apply pressure, I want to apply pressure. So different types. Solving procedure, whatever the concepts you will be in, and solver you will apply those all the procedures, and in post processing you will get the result of how much you have applied, you have taken the materials, you have taken the 3D model, and you have solved some, giving the load conditions on the 3D model by using the solver. So these all things I have collected. Then what happens to the prototype, or what happened to the model, in you can check in the post processing. So for example, here in the structure analysis, it covers the all these portions. So first, engineering materials you have to choose. If you want default example, means defaultly in structural steel it is already taken, then you will go for the geometry. This tick mark is there, na compulsory, it should get the green tick mark. So then only it will apply. Then model, then setup. Here setup, you will give the load conditions. Then solution and results are post-processing. And pre-processing means giving the materials, creating a geometry. Model and setup, you will do the load conditions. Then the post-processing. It takes time directly by seeing. I don't want to explain you by doing fast and see. I'll see this is the analysis and all. Please give me time to explain a small concept. Listen carefully. You will feel very happy by, you will think that it is very creativity software. We have to learn that thing. I want to get that thing for you. Please, listen that. So now I have taken this beam and clicking on this beam, I can change the materials here. See, material is there now. So you, I have already selected materials. So now structural steel is there. And I want to change the materials. So here already, which I have selected in the engineering data, whatever you have selected and you have done, okay, those materials you will be finding here. So here I'm finding concrete and stainless steel materials. So if you want to do on structural steel only, continue with this. If you want to change, click on the concrete. Concrete material applications will be applied on that. So structural steel is there. So now is done. Then what is this mesh? Compulsory mesh generation. So in this mesh generation, you will be finding all accurate result. To get the accurate result only, you will create a mesh. For example, if I like nodes and elements are the main thing which are introduced in this mesh concept. So depends on number of nodes and elements only, your analysis result will be based. So if I give very fine mesh, then your nodes and elements will be high. If I give random mesh, then you will have tightly. So when I apply load on a normal mesh thing, when I apply a load, what result I'll get? When I increase the mesh application, what result I'll get? You can see. So accurate result, you can, to get an accuracy result only, for getting the accuracy result only, we will do the mesh procedure. Okay. So in hypermesh software, maximum this sort of work you will do. But why we are doing an analysis means in hypermesh, nowadays recently you can do the analysis application and all. But previous versions, you can do only mesh, creating a component and mesh generation only you can do in that softwares. Now, recently we have got a new version, there you can do the analysis procedure also. So advanced options you got. But now, so but in analysis, pre-processing, solver, post-processing, three procedures you can do. Means doing 3D analysis also. So here I'm doing creating mesh. See, very mesh randomly I got. If I want very fine mesh, then I'll go and I'll change. So different types of shapes you will be finding in the mesh properties. So when you have given the fine mesh, you can check how many nodes and elements we have. So when we are doing a project, by directly you won't have, like you will take the help of some journals, already published journals, your seniors or professors who have done, by checking, by doing that, taking the examples from the journals only, you will learn the softwares. That is the best example to get the sensor software learn very easily. So there, even in there also, they will intimate, okay, this particular rectangle is there, you have to extrude this much, you have to give this much nodes. They won't give the mesh quantity, this much nodes, this much elements. So here you will see the nodes and elements value. If I want less thing, then two procedures are there. After starting the class, I'll tell you. This is one procedure. Immediately I want to decrease the nodes and elements means see. You have decreased the nodes and elements values. So I want to apply a load on this much nodes and elements quantity of a model. So and then you will continue like this. So next, now pre-processing done, geometry, mesh. Now solver, static structure analysis, you will learn these concepts. So now I want to apply force. I'm applying. So now you can see in upward direction is there, but I don't want in upward direction. I want in downward direction. Then here in directions, you will change it. See, load, upload, download. So I the direct applying load force, you will get the result. No, you should give fixed support. So where you will give the fixed supports? Here you are having the support area. You will select fix. So if you want only one side should be, if you want only one side fixed, then click here face. Apply it to fixed. Okay, then solver is done. Now I want to see, there are so many things. Now I want to see only total deformation. So in this beam examples, we can cover minimum 10 example, 10 problems, different types of 10 problems you can create. This is very small for giving the what is ANSYS, what you do in ANSYS. To get that idea, I have done very small topic only. But when we go for the class, we can learn very depthly. Okay. See now, what are these countering things? So when I applied load, these are the minimum and maximum results which I have got with particular material and all. See, these are the counters thing. Animation also you can see. If you do this practically, can you see? Acha, when I applied this particular load, it is happening like this. So how you know that it is failure? Here time limit will be there. Scaling will be there. If I keep in undeformed state, and see, if you learn Feintellman methods, topics, some subjects will be there. You can learn it afterwards also. How you want to learn these all topics, what is deformation, what is this undeformed, everything. I'll guide you some books, what to learn and all, some PDFs are there. From there, you can learn and get some sort of knowledge to complete your graduation with good projects, or afterwards to get knowledge, I'll help you. But you have to learn some words. What is this? What is that? To explain to the person and all. See, now it is animating. I want to see in one view only. In this view, it is animating like this. If you want to see more damaged state, I don't want to increase the force. I don't want to change the material. But I want to see the worst stage, damage, over deformed stage. So it is not moving now. When I kept in undeformed stage, only analysis is applied, but you cannot see the animation, or you cannot see the visualization of deformation stages of that particular material. Then to show to the client, you will show like this. The client will ask you, you have applied this force, no? Show me the undeformed stage. Then you'll go there. I want some scale reputation to for the deformation of a tool. So how you'll show, you'll do. If I want more scale, see, bending. So in software only, in the software, you have to be clearly that I know 2D, you have to do 3D diagram perfectly, you have to do 3D diagram perfectly, and what are the load conditions, or what are the concept to complete that analysis procedure. If you know that thing, only apply that values here and do the analysis, you will get the result. Suppose if I want bending moment, bending scale, what you will do? I didn't, how can you get in the middle bending? If I gave an only one side support, how can you get the result of in the middle bending moment? How you'll get the result? See, now when I applied in the middle, I got 0 to 0.00077. But if I, that is for what? Structural steel. What is the result when I applied this particular forces on concrete material? What happens? You have to select, right click, update the geometry. Then you will get the results. Your results will be changed. So you will get the idea Okay, when I applied for the structural steel, this much force, I have got the result. When I applied for this concrete, this was the result. So accuracy result, you have to go and solve. It takes time because even whenever you are having this softwares, you should have some graphic user solvers also. Two minutes. See, the result was changed. See, when I did for structural steel, you got the result of 0.0007. So when you have applied the concrete, means when on structural steel I have applied 650 newton mm square load, the damage is getting more compared with the concrete. So here you can compare which material is better to do the, for the manufacturer, to, for the product to be done successfully. So when I applied the same load on the concrete material, I got less damage when compared with the structural steel. So here you'll compare an analysis. Analysis is only for the estimation. So by doing this, by getting this accuracy result only, we will complete our project successfully without getting n number of errors. To only some sort of errors only we'll get. If you do directly, you'll get many errors. So what happens? Material will be wasted, time will be wasted, workload will be happen, manpower will be. So to reduce all these things, technically, we design engineers learn this some sort of softwares technically and clear the problems of some manufacturers or some clients or and all. Then we'll solve the problems. So same thing you can do. And bending moment, everything if you want to do means just add this another fixed support. So if one fixed support I have given in this end, na? Second fixed support you give in another end. Then only when two sets, if it gets fixed only, na, you will have the bending moment. Okay, now go for the solve. So see the result, see the animation. Now you can see it is in true scale. When it is in true scale, means one ratio, 1:1 ratio, you cannot see the bending moment. So when you increase the scale factor, see, you can see the bending. So final thing, you have done everything, applied materials, and see the result how you got at each stage. So if I want to see what, how much numerical values I got in some stages, how we want to see. See, one error if you find, see, I have done the geometry in meters, millimeters, but analysis is done in meters. So readings also will get different. So here also you should do that. What do you want to do is you should change the units, then see the value of result, it changed or not. And I went for meters, I got this much value. So convert. So automatically software will converts the numerical values and gives us the best result, accuracy result. So if I want in mm result, I can change. Understood? So it's a very small example. So when I applied the load in 1 minute of time, in on 1 minute on this beam, I applied 650 newtons load. So what happened to the thing and how much minimum and maximum accuracy result we got? So comparing with the materials and all, you will check like this n number of designs, even complex designs also you can solve in the ANSYS softwares. But the important thing is you should be perfect in 3D modeling. You should learn the 3D modeling and do the designs, n number of designs, whatever you can do, you can learn the softwares by doing n number of designs, whatever daily, whatever you see, bottle, cap, screw, nut, whatever, different chair, take different examples, identify those materials, apply, think how much load we have to give on, doing the software, then only you will learn the software. By books or by anything, you won't learn the softwares. only by doing the practical examples. After learning this tools and all, you can go for professionally by learning from journals, doing number of paper from experiments, number of things from journals, different examples. In so many examples, you can learn successfully this software. So I want to show you the advantage of this software is, I told you, now my project is of this beam. I have done the analysis in the software. Then how I will show to my client the report and all. I told you that here you will automatic report, you will find out. See, this is a print view one. In this geometry area, you will get the geometry. This is the print view, and this, see here, everything it will take out. On which day you have done, what software, it's a proof. Maximum so many people can do in different and they'll show without proof. So here you can show the proof. I have done my project by using Ansys software with 16 version, and I have done it. And this was the report. You can show clearly. Hence, your project is finished. In middle, you will add some theory applications and all. But whatever, however you want, you cannot do the thing in a particular way. Some procedures only you should do the. My suggestion is some procedures you have to follow for doing the projects and all. See everything, units, whatever you have done, all the units, all the things you will get. But you can ask me, ma'am, you have created some diagrams, you have done, and some colors you got, some animations, everything. Where are these? How can I show you? Then wherever you go, like this is the thing, you can take a picture. So here at the top you'll have figure, but if you want color for this, what you'll do, you'll select the geometry. So transparency without transparency. See color. So now you want to show this color in the report to figure. Here you'll get mesh. You want to increase the mesh, and you want accuracy, more accuracy result. Then you'll go like this. Solve. So let it get complete. Select the mesh, get it figure. Then what are loads you have applied? You want to show at a time in the report. If you want to show individually, if you select force, again take this figure. If you want to show static structural in analysis, in this much time I have applied this many supports, load conditions and all, then go directly figure it out. This is total deformation. If I want direction deformation result, then right click deformation direction. In which direction I'm applying load on y direction. So I want to get the only y direction result. I don't want complete body. I don't want complete tool result. Only in y direction when I applied, what is the result? I want to get it. And select the apply, solve. See, different result here. Complete body, I applied 650 newtons now on complete concrete material, complete body, this was the result. Only on the surface, only on the upward, in y direction, only on the in one direction when the load gets done, how much I got, this is the result. So there are so much to learn. We'll happily, if you all liked my thing, we'll learn happily. Okay, so finally, I want to show you the report view. So till now I have taken the figures. So report view. This is the report generation process. So this thing in APDL, you cannot get this much flexibility. In APDL, only with the concept commands thing only you will get it. But in workbench, we'll get complete report generation. automatically. See, now every can see. Previously, I didn't get my picture of whatever product I have done. Then after going that, how much units I have applied, completed. These all things, did I apply? No. Oh, some in data, like which is similar for all the analysis procedures, some data will be stored automatically in this. If you want to change personally, then you can go to that procedures and you can change individual growth rate. I don't want this much growth rate. I can increase the ratio. So some things you can edit and do, but defaultly in package it will be saved. So that thing only you'll get in the result. So this is the mesh. So in mesh, how many nodes and how much things I got, also you can check it. The model structure analysis. See in nodes 2033 and elements. So client will say, ma'am, I don't want this much. I want to increase the nodes and all. Then how much result I'll get? I want to see strength of my material condition. I want to check with respect to values, accurate result. Then you can change there. Go back to the model, geometry, change the mesh application. Again, you'll get the different result. So these are the things. So here you can give the graphs also. So I have applied only one load, no? Directly. I'll get one direct application load. If you apply intervals, you'll get different graphs. So load applications, see. What all pictures you will get here, those pictures you will find it. Okay, see bulk modulus, shear modulus, these all data are done in engineering data. So finally, I want to send this report to my client. Then go to send to option. It will be converted into Word. It will be converted into the PPT also. So if you want to present this report, if you want to present the procedure directly, you cannot again create in the PPT individually. No? From software only, direct documentary is converting into the PDF and the Word. So now it will change to the Word. Takes time. So if this animation is there, total deformation, go to geometry, report will come, I'll tell you. So this animation is there. You want speed animation, slow animation. If you want speed animation, you can see. If you want to download this animation video also, you can do here. See, saving the file now, export the video file. So here also you can, so through different things, you can save the file. Save. Then when you go there, you can see that file. So in the report, did I get my report? Wait a minute. If you do another any changes, again here changes will happen. You want to publish this video, you can publish. You want to change the font of the PPT, you can change. You want to take print out also, directly you can take out print option. Or else do right click on the report. Here all things you'll get, print view option, export to Microsoft Excel. Even the readings, what are the material data? See, complete this all material data you cannot type in the Word, then you cannot share. Now, direct this report should be sent in Excel form also, export to Excel, you'll get. Takes time. So this is the importance of this software. I hope you all liked this small example. And I have done some small CFD analysis, small topics only you can see. In CFD analysis, I have created some tab will be there, no? In tab, suppose if you at a time, the tap is connected to the geyser and normal valve. So when you are applying hot water, and at a time when the flow of hot water and cold water is coming, then what will be the result? What is the flow? CFD analysis, like that you can get it, see in Excel. So this is the Word. In Word I got everything. You can import and export also. And this is the Excel thing. So my system is getting slow. I'll show you again. So some examples I have done on students' projects also. So this simple example, I want to show the CFD flow analysis. And finally, did my project is successful or not? Is a failure or successful? Why? Because I have randomly taken one rectangle value, I have extruded and applied load, and I am changed the materials and all. Is it done correctly? How you know that means? Go to the main page here. All tick marks only you should get. Okay. When you get all green colors only, the status is that your analysis is done perfectly. And if you have get any errors, if you have done anywhere in the middle, either question mark you will get or cross symbol you will get, then either in engineering data, if you have given, you have not selected the particulars, engineering material particulars, there only it will show question mark or cross. Cross when it will show means failed thing only it will show. Here in the geometry, whenever you have not created properly, if you create here in Ansys Workbench, some basic, if you create here elements, no, maximum you won't get problems. When you get the problems is when you import from other 3D modeling softwares. If there with the perfect scale, if you are not doing properly, or somewhere importing IGS files or STP files, if you are not doing properly, means it won't import to the Ansys. Then when it won't import to the Ansys software, you cannot do analysis. So some basic precautions you have to take. If you get any errors, means down, show messages will be there. So this is some simple Microsoft that is depends on the system configuration you'll get. But if you get any errors in that, you have chosen beyond the limit of load you have given, on small thing you have given more load, or mesh generation you have not done properly. So each and every stage of this analysis procedure, you'll get messages here. If you want to see, you can see, or you can hide. Where is my video? Is it? So this is a small example video. I want to show that how the fluid analysis example is done. This is a vast big software. You have to learn each and everything very clearly, then only you will have more interest and all. If you will do normally, means see, you can play with the softwares, you can learn different things and do analysis like passion. You can create the software, like you can do more wonders by using the softwares, getting the good result. First, learning is important. So you should learn perfectly. So these different types. So here the flow, like this flow you are seeing. Streamlines, these are called as streamlines, flow streamlines. So you, these are things. So water flow is happening, depends on, these are the velocity factors, these are the ranges in between them the flow is applying.